guide you, to direct you, to love on you, to live in you. Is there anybody that knows? Is there anybody that knows? Can I tell you one more thing? Your story may not be my story.
Welcome our visitors, amen. Before we give our offering and our tithes, we just like to welcome those that in the house on today. I guess the other ones is caught up on the back to yesterday's time, but it's a new time and it's a new day, and we can't miss what God is doing. Am I right about it? You got to be on time and you got to be ready for the move of God. When God get ready to move, you got to move just like that. Hallelujah, amen. Bless the Lord.
We shall rejoice and be glad in it. So I just like to thank the Lord. We welcome our guests on today.
Yes, Lord.
On the behalf of Pastor Willie and his absent, Pastor Jackson, welcome everyone here today.
Yes, Lord.
We hope you come back.
Yes.
And break bread with us on today.
Yes, Lord.
Glory to God.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
So we have visitors. Would you like to stand and just say something? I'm not forcing you. Okay.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Glory.
That's all right.
All right.
I'm Doug Richardson. Hi, Andrea. I work with Marcus, and we spend a lot of time in the car together and talking, and he blesses me greatly.
All right. God bless.
Thank you. I'm Andrea. I'm Doug's wife.
And,
I know he said that, but I have a voice to share. And I thank God for the wonderful people that he works with, including Marcus.
Yeah.
Thanks very much. And as the scriptures say, where two or three are gathered together in his name, there he is.
Yes.
So thank you very much for spreading the word of God and for being positive and joyful. And let us just continue rejoicing. I mean, we live in very perilous times these days. And we know our faith is under attack daily.
Yes.
We know the trials and tribulations and challenges we go through on a daily basis.
Yes.
And, you know, it's really hard to keep the faith in these times.
Yes.
But
yes.
We have to continue the walk. We have
amen.
To stay strong. And we have to show the world that, you know what, we have greatest healing that is in us than he who is in the world.
We're
so careful these days about what is happening in our communities, in our country, in our world. But as I keep on saying, God is still in control. He is in control. And greater is he than any man in this world. So let's just, you know, amidst all the challenges that we go through on a daily basis, we just ask the Lord to give us faith and strength to continue serving him and to grow day by day, so that he who is out there in the world can look at us and want what it is that we have and want to know our Lord Jesus Christ. So thanks again. Continue the great work, folks.
Our problem is not the possessors, but the professor.
Yes. Praise Amen. God.
But we thank God Amen. For you, and we pray that you come back and worship with us.
Yes, Lord.
And you did have a whole lot to say. You blessed us. So thank you.
Amen.
Thank you again.
Amen.
All right.
Yes.
Amen. Okay, it's offering time. Oh, yes.
Those that will be given at this time can please stand, come through the middle aisle, and give your offering as she leads you. Amen. We thank God for you being in the presence of the Lord today. We do honor to do the will of the Lord over here. We do love God. Amen. Your testimony, woman of God, I love the words that you spoke, you and your husband. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Amen. We love you.
Oh, precious Father God, we thank you, Lord, for everyone that gave on today. And we ask you even now, Father, look upon those that got a free heart to give. Continue to bless them in the righteous name of Jesus. And those that may not have anything to give, God bless them that they be able to give in the righteous name of Jesus. And Father God, we ask you to bless this offering, that it will go further and do more. In Jesus' wonderful name, we thank you. For little is much in the hands of God. Amen.
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 Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank the Lord for this day. Isn't it a beautiful Sunday today? This weekend turned out to be so beautiful. I've just been enjoying myself this whole weekend. This is baby shower. Just a beautiful weekend. I just enjoyed everything. Amen. It was such a beautiful job. Amen. We thank the Lord. I missed my husband today in his absence. Giving honor to him in his absence. Amen. He will be here next Sunday or Wednesday night, though. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Keep them in your prayer, you know, after you have surgery. Body comes in and out. But God is good, amen? I'm going to praise and form today. Amen. Because I know Pastor Marcus is getting ready to come with the awesome word. Amen. And if our hearts is open to receive, it'll even be more. Amen. Don't make it hard for the man of God to go forth with the word of the Lord on the day. Let your hearts be receptive and open. Amen. Come on. This is an awesome man to God. I thank God that he has linked up with us in ministry because we kind of got a kindred spirit. We become yesterday. He said, uh-oh, you almost dressed like me, Pastor. And I said, I said, because see, we down to earth. Real people. We real people over here. What you see is what you get. Amen. We love people. And our love is for real. We love people for real. There's no big eyes and no little U's over here. Everybody is great in the kingdom of God. And he said he has gifted us all. And he has given us all gifts and talents. Amen. And when we're not intimidated as a body of Christ, we can flow together. Because he has something I need. Amen. And I have something he needs. And when we come together, it's like Kool-Aid. It tastes real good. Amen. When you shake it all up at the end of the day, we got some good stuff. Let God use you, man. To God, I love you much. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Oh, my God. I'm so happy everybody has attended today. You didn't have to be here, but you chose to be here today. And I'm so happy that you chose to be here in this house today.
Amen.
As Pastor Ruthie always say, you know, well, we may be short as a people, even if I got to speak to these chairs, but the word is going to flow. Praise God, but we are growing. As she has said, we have linked up with my ministry, with her ministry, and I'm coming in on this ministry to sit up under her. She's an awesome woman of God, and for Doug, a good friend of mine that had attended today, I really appreciate you and so forth. And you are very, you're an inspiration to me as well. The conversations that we have, we have taught me some things, and you know, you kind of put some things in me that helped me kind of with my faith and with the things that I needed to do, and I thank you for that, and I appreciate you for showing up and so forth, as I invited many others from the workplace, but we all, me and you both know what kind of workplace we come from, but at the same token, it shows who's there for, and I appreciate you and your family, that I love you, thank you. Now, no further ado, everybody that knows my preaching, you know, I'm a little bit, I kind of have you like a bobblehead. I have you going, you know, but I'm going to kind of slow down a little bit because this message to me is going to be a little bit personal. The Lord has given me this, and I want to be able to share this. Can everybody hear me without this microphone? Okay. And the reason why this message is so personal to me, and he's given me this message because he wanted to share this with me as well, and as well as for you to be able to receive what I got for you upon today. And today's message, it's a coming out message. It's a coming out party for you. It's shedding light upon you, because this message is, it briefly is, I'm tired in the dark place. Many of us are in the dark place. In that dark place, sometimes will get us to a place where we have to think, to sit us down, so therefore we can be able to understand what is happening and what is he trying to show us. My dark place, I lived in the dark place. Oh my God. I've been there. I experienced it. I understand it. I went through it. I went through all the trials and the tribulations, and I've been in the streets. The streets tried to kill me. You know, like Pastor Shirley said, you know, I did weed, speed, sex, wet, you name it!
Oh, God.
Huh? I did it. I've been there. I've done that. I know what it is.
Yes, Lord.
Like Pastor Weber said, you can't just preach this thing if you ain't never been through nothing. But see, let me explain something to you. Let me share a little bit of something for you. I done been through it all. I done been in the streets. I done been in the gangs. I know what it is to be sitting in the car high, trying to park it in the garage and knock off the handle. And I'm telling her to go in there and get me some tape so I can wrap it around. And she telling me what you need tape for. I said, let me use it. The next day she pulled out the car. And I had the whole bag taped up. Oh my God. I said, wait a minute, what is this? I'm talking about late nights. I'm talking about in the streets. I'm talking about shooting. I done seen the thing here. I know what it is to be without food. I know what it is to hang out late. I know what it is because I have experienced so much in a lifetime that my life is a novel. Yes, but I'm here today because of what he has saved me. Yes, before I was living so much in darkness, I couldn't understand it.
Yes, Lord Jesus. Mm-hmm. Yes.
My brother was killed by my best friend.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
My son died at 1 year old. Jesus. I remember I linked up with this girl. I've been wanting to date this girl for a long time. Long time. She finally liked me. We dated 2 weeks. Oh, my God. The next day she was going to work, they found her dead in the car. Her head slumped over there and shot her in the head. The same guy that I was hanging out with, you remember, we just got a car. It ain't only been two days old. I'm hanging out drinking. My boy threw up in the car. I come back. She said, what happened? I said, we was hanging out late the next day. My other friend told me, he said, you know what? He died. They shot him and killed him.
Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, yes.
Hanging out in the streets.
Yes.
See, I was a Crip.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was from a notorious gang, 102nd Street.
Okay.
They shooting dice out there. He get mad, he shoot him in the head. I'm looking at my shoes. There's red noodles on them. I'm saying, what? It look like noodles. This is scared me. They telling stories about how he shot him and he got away. They ran over a little baby. They laughing about it. I don't know whether I should tell the police or just keep quiet. At that time, I had to keep quiet. But I wanted to tell the police. But I'm going to share something with you. But all the things that, and not to add, I done graduated.
Yes, Lord.
I've been in jail. I know what it's like to be there.
Yes.
I know what it's like to not to go from family and from family and they kicked me out. I didn't have nowhere to go.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
I don't want to sit here to make a scene like this is my mother and I love her so much. Prophetess and pastor in that gift. I love her so much. But see, the thing is, you know, at a point in time, she's a good mother, but at a point in time we go through things. So she had to go clean up some stuff. So therefore it left me out there. Praise God, I had my sister. She was young, had children. I was such a fool. You know, it just didn't work out.
Yes, Lord. Yeah.
I was just too much. I'm out there now. I'm trying to figure out what I'm going to do. I don't know how I'm going to get my meal. I don't know where I'm going to sleep. I don't know where I'm going to lay the next day. I'm just out in the streets. I'm in the neighborhood. I really don't want to be there. And I'm telling my, you know, and it just seemed like it was all went to waste. You see, I wasn't a bad kid because, see, my mama tell you right now, I was supposed to be a basketball player. I had UNLV looking at me to go play. But I said, you know what? That don't look bright right now. I got to get through this. So I seen my brothers, and they wasn't so much of a good example. So I seen the things that they have done. So I had to choose what they were doing. And I said, let me go where the streets is at. The homeboys look a little more safe. It looked like a Unity thing. They making fast money. Let me see if I can get in where I fit in. But I didn't fit in because, see, now I understand it now. Because in the dark place, now he exposed it to me. The reason why I didn't fit in because I didn't belong. But I had to go through. And the whole time that I was going through, Doug, but guess what? He kept me so safe because all the things that I was going through, I'm supposed to have been dead or set up or in jail. Yeah, I'm on it for 3 years right now, but he kept me safe. He was hugging me. He was holding me on. Because he said, I'm going to get you to this point eventually to where you need to be. And that's the dark place. But the dark place has brought me to the light.
Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, yes. Amen. Yes, yes.
The dark place.
Yeah.
A lot of us in the dark place.
Yeah.
But we don't understand why we're in the dark place. I'm getting to the word. We don't understand why we're in the dark place. The dark place will get you to a place to make you think. It ain't that your husband is in a wheelchair. I've known him. I used to see this man walk. But see, God is not making him suffer. It is making him see things, because when he come out of this, he's going to see. That's just like for you. You in the dark place. But see, a lot of people don't understand your dark place, but the Lord is going to bring you out. And the reason why he's going to bring you out, and the reason why these things are happening, because he got a better purpose for you. He said, I got to put you here so you can be able to think just a little bit. And the reason why, because I want to see how strong and how tough is your faith. And that's why all these things are coming against you to attack you, because of what he's trying to do for you. And ain't that he don't want to, but he is going to. But guess what? It is a dark place, but he's shedding light on you. And the reason why, because he knows what your faith is. We have to be able to go through something, because you've been in this world long enough, and you don't have your testimony, but he's got to bring something up. He said, let me stir up the pot again. I got to make sure she's full for. And he's seeing that. That's why this church is going to be gone, and we're advancing to something bigger. He is opening up. He is opening up the floodgates to heaven. And most of us are in the dark place. It's okay. You know the conversation we had. But it's okay. Dark place. Sometimes in a dark place, sometimes we got to go through. This man done went through so much. Because not only he lost his brother and his father, that my best friend killed his father, which is my nephew, and his brother, which is my nephew, died later on in life. And you think he's not going through something? But God is showing you something. See, a lot of people can't go through what you're going through. And you might be going through a lot of stuff right now, but the Lord is showing you something. Because you're about to come out of this dark place. Because after you come out of the dark place, after he fully let you see what he's trying to show you, it's going to be light. There's always light at the end of the tunnel.
Amen.
He's showing you something. Stay strong. He's showing you something.
Amen.
In the dark place. You in the dark place. But you coming out of the dark place. Yes. Faithful woman of God. Coming out. It's your coming out party.
Amen.
See, it ain't that sometimes.